What is up, guys? Rick Kakis here. Thank you so much for stopping by. And today, Bungie released a brand new massive trailer for Destiny 2 Beyond Light, detailing 4 new exotic weapons and 6 new exotic armor pieces for 10 brand new Beyond Light exotics total. This was actually accompanied by a huge website update which further detailed these new exotics. So we're going to be combining those pieces of information, breaking everything down to showcase what you're going to be equipping when Beyond Light launches, and so let's get started. But just before we do, a huge amount of people watching the channel aren't yet subscribed. Take a quick second to hit that subscribe button, ring that bell, and be notified of content similar to this, and you can always unsubscribe later. All right, now let's start out here with the 4 new exotic weapons. Firstly, we have the No Time to Explain. Now, this exotic pulse rifle is actually the pre-order bonus for Beyond Light, and it was also available within Destiny 1. In that game, it would simply refund shots into the magazine if they were precision. But in Beyond Light, it's quite a bit different. So it says precision hits and hits against enemies affected by stasis will return to the magazine. So that is similar to Destiny 1. But you can stack this effect to summon a portal which will fire bullets from an alternate timeline of the weapon. That is completely unique, and that seems pretty darn powerful. I mean, your Arc buddy, your Arc soul within Destiny 2 right now, there's already some Arc soul builds that are pretty nasty in PvP. Having that extra damage going forward towards an enemy certainly does matter. And imagine this weapon combined with an Arc buddy. Like, you're gonna have 2 things shooting enemies without you having to do anything. Are you just gonna be able to walk around and let your buddies kill everything for you? Could be. Moving on from there, the next weapon we're gonna look at is a new exotic sniper rifle called the Cloud Strike. Now, what this weapon does is that precision final blows will generate lightning bolts at the target location. Rapid precision shots will summon an entire storm at the point of impact. Guys, this is the Thunderlord in sniper rifle form, and that seems very, very powerful, especially because sniper rifles are one of the best weapons for DPS within PvE. So not only will you be able to land multiple precision shots in a row, which is already great damage, but now you're gonna be able to summon a storm for doing so. Note that storm is summoned regardless of whether or not you got a kill, so that is perfect for damage against bosses. I'm very excited for this thing. Not to mention in PvP, especially if the gameplay is to be believed, if those lightning bolts are potentially a one-shot kill or close to it, that could be really powerful as well. Now, moving on from there, we finally have a new exotic sword with the Lament. Now, it says here, a mortal blade, a stalwart shield, block with the Lament to rev the blade, then shred through shielded enemies. At its peak, damaging an enemy will heal the wielder. This is an interesting one, because obviously being able to break through shielded enemies, the first thing that comes to my mind is barrier champions. And if it can shred through those and then kill the champion behind it very quickly, obviously that's quite powerful. However, getting up close and personal is never really recommended in a Grandmaster Nightfall, for example. With that being said, blocking with the sword to charge up the blade, so to speak, especially if that charge up is accompanied by more damage as well, and then being able to unleash that and also heal yourself, I mean, when you're up close and personal with a sword, the one thing you really want to do often is to heal yourself. And I see so many people, you know, going out on their swords, so to speak, with the Fallen Guillotine, for example, when they're just trying to DPS a boss and getting stomped, and they really do need that healing, and they'll often, like, die just trying to get damage in, so the Lament could be very good for preventing that. But moving on from there, the last exotic weapon showcased today was a new exotic grenade launcher called the Salvation's Grip. Now, what this weapon does is that each fired projectile will create stasis crystals that will freeze nearby targets, charged to increase the amount of crystals created and the freeze radius. So it's basically a mobile stasis subclass. Who needs to pick that new stasis subclass when you can bring the Salvation's Grip with you and just freeze everything by shooting it? Now, especially because those stasis crystals, remember, they are physical objects in the world. And that gives this thing so much versatility. You can use it to create cover if you need to heal. You can block off a choke point. You can do a lot of stuff with those stasis crystals. So I'm very excited for it. Now, moving on from there, again, we have 6 new exotic armor pieces. So let's start here with a new Titan exotic gauntlet, the Icefall Mantle. Now, what this does is, well, Bungie says, stand tall against the oncoming hordes with this reinforced armor that replaces the Titan's barricade with an overshield, absorbing damage from incoming fire. Holy crap. So instead of putting down a barricade, you can now use your class ability button and just give yourself an overshield. That is incredibly powerful. Like, I am actually shocked that this is in the game, because I mean, for PvP, just being able to, you know, put a ton of your stats into resilience, so you get your class ability every like 10 seconds, so you can have an overshield every 10 seconds in PvP, pop this, go around a corner, win every gunfight. Wow. Feels good to be a Titan main right now, let me tell you, holy crap. Moving on from there, the next exotic armor piece we have is another Titan exotic, this time a helmet with the Precious Scars. So Bungie says, improve your strength even when coming back from the brink. Upon revives, the Titan gains an overshield aura that protects the wearer and nearby allies. Now, I've got to be honest with you guys, this is the one I'm not too excited for. I'm not a fan of exotics that only work when you're revived, because if you're playing well, it'll never even be active. With that being said, I cannot possibly think of something more annoying to face in trials. Like, kill a guy, they get a revive, and then they get an overshield aura for them and the person that revived them. Like, that just seems like a nightmare to face, and also pretty useful in Grandmasters as well if you're going down a lot too. So, I mean, it could actually be pretty good. Moving on from there, the next armor piece we have is a Hunter exotic helmet, the Mask of Bacchus. Now, what this does is, Bungie says, don the mask to replace the Hunter's dodge ability with a longer range shift ability that also temporarily cloaks the wearer during use. And you can see in the background gameplay, this new shift ability is basically like a blink, but potentially faster, more nimble, and that is super powerful. Anytime you give hunters more mobility, oof, they just take it to the nth degree, and I expect this thing to turn up quite a bit in PvP. Like, this seems actually quite useful. But moving on from there, the next thing we have here is another Hunter exotic with the Arthrissa's Embrace exotic gauntlets. So what these do is that the Hunter's weighted knife gains a second ricochet, rapid precision hits gain a damage bonus, and can temporarily stagger enemies. Okay, so those are two very different but very powerful things going on. Obviously, weighted knife getting another bounce, that's pretty situational, but can definitely come up, and the weighted knife, even if it doesn't get a precision shot, does quite a lot of damage. But then that second part, where rapid precision hits gain a damage bonus, I mean, that seems just incredible, because that seems to apply to any weapon, any scenario. So PvE, do more damage, even like boss DPS, your rapid shooting, you know, that new exotic sniper rifle we looked at earlier, getting even more damage from these. And in PvP, being able to potentially kill and one-shot less with certain weapons if you're getting a damage bonus, like, this seems incredibly good. But we've got to move on to the Warlock exotics here, firstly with a new exotic helmet, the Dawn Chorus. So Bungie says, feel that sweet burn. The Warlock's Daybreak projectiles deal extra damage and cause enemies to burn on contact. Gain melee energy each time a burn damages a target. Now this seems pretty decent. Firstly, improving your Daybreak, and secondly, remember that last part is disconnected from Daybreak. If you make enemies burn with a grenade, for example, you're still gonna gain a bunch of melee energy from this thing, and that seems actually quite powerful. Not to mention, the bottom tree Daybreak, where kills extend its duration, is pretty decent for certain PvE activities. If this thing is giving an actual significant damage bonus, that subclass, like, that just got a lot better for PvE. But moving on from there, the last exotic we're covering today is the new Warlock exotic gauntlets, the Necrotic Grip. So Bungie says, a deadly caress compounded. Melee attacks corrupt enemies with increased damage over time. Defeating a corrupted combatant spreads the corruption to nearby targets and restores melee energy. Wow, okay, so this seems pretty interesting. Who needs Thorn when your melee now becomes a thorn, essentially? Now, being able to just spread damage over time, that is a very powerful ability. Especially if this actually works with all of the Warlock's ranged melees. Imagine using top tree Dawnblade to just yeet out a melee across the map and then spread this damage over time debuff. Like, that seems like a really powerful combo. Also, these seem similar to another really powerful exotic, the Dune Marchers, in terms of that spreading effect. Like, when you're using the Dune Marchers right now, you kill an enemy with that charge up lightning energy, and it can chain to enemies you don't even see, like they're behind walls. The chaining effect is pretty darn large. The Necrotic Grip could do that same thing. You kill an enemy with a melee because they're right in your face, and then their ally, you know, in the next room, if it's a large radius that it goes to, will be affected and start getting damage over time, and then you or your allies can deal with that guy not at full health. Like, that seems pretty powerful too. In any event, guys, that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed, found this informative, and if you did, please remember to help me out by simply rating and especially sharing this video. If you guys want to see more Destiny 2 content similar to this, don't be afraid to slap that subscribe button. If you want to get in touch with me and keep up to date with the latest channel activity, the best way is to follow me on Twitter at @RickKakis. That's linked in the description down below. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, have a good day.